to prayer and Shabbat. This is a Shabbat song, right? Are you ready? Are you ready for Shabbat? For Shabbat. Ready for the candles. Ready for the candles. For Shabbat.
For Shabbat.
What else do we need for Shabbat? Dory. Are you ready?
Are you ready for Shabbat? For Shabbat.
Ready for the to be challah. Ready to be challah. Good, great, Kiddush.
Are you ready? Are you ready for Shabbat? For Shabbat.
Ready to make Kiddush.
Ready to make Kiddush for Shabbat. For Shabbat.
In much of the materials that I will give over to you today, be it songs, finger plays, games, I look to include the children in all of those parts. Ideas for the song,
what was the other thing I wanted
to... Oh, and to try to get them to be a part, you'll see in a minute, because you're going to be the kids today, all right? So this is really small room, but I'm just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Could you 8 come up and make a circle? Great. Susan, you get to be in the middle. try to make the circle as big as you can. I know you won't be able to hold here. So this is the Shabbos pony. So Susan, you're gonna ride on your pony. Okay? In a minute. The circle's gonna go that way, and Susan's, you're gonna go in opposite directions, okay? So, if you can hold hands, feel free, but we're kind of limited here. So we go. Here comes Susan on her pony, riding on her Shabbat pony. Here comes Susan on her pony. This is how we do it. Now this is how we do it, I'm gonna show you. Front to front to front. Oh baby, side to side to side. Oh baby, back to back to back. Oh baby, this is how we do it. Now you missed it, so what are we gonna do that about? Front to front to front to front. Oh baby, side to side to side. Oh baby, back to back to back. Oh baby, this is how we do it. And now Rachel and Susan are going to go. Circle, go. Here comes Rachel on her pony.
That was cute.
Okay, so that song.
I gotcha.
That song, as opposed really to probably 99% of the songs that we do for Shabbat, had no challah, no kiddush, no candles, none of that. But I am telling you, if you incorporate that into your Shabbat
routine,
yes, they love it. They just love it. I don't know why, but they love it. So they love when you take a turn, by the way. So you can do it like with, and pick your assistant just to demonstrate the thing to them. Could you remind me to just say machaser, what's missing? Because I want to say something about it, but not right now, and I'm going to forget. So you're the machaser girl, okay? Here we go. Rosh Hashanah, we're done with it. This is like one of my favorite all-time songs. And if you know it, we're just going to skip over it. Because you don't need it till next year anyway, but it goes, you all do Rosh Hashanah?
Yeah.
Yes.
You have a shofar in your class?
Yes.
Of course.
Somebody comes and blows it?
Yes.
Right? We got all that. Okay, so it goes, I like to hear the shofar blast,
sometimes slow and sometimes fast. I like to hear the shofar blast. Happy, happy, happy New Year. Yeah.
Okay, so you know that when you do a Shvarim Truan Tkiyah Gdolah, when we sing that in my school, we don't, well, just when we get to I like to hear the chauffeur sometimes slow.
And sometimes they just go insane for that. I don't know why.
So just a way to like juice up the song. Now, sitting in the sun. Sorry. We find. Okay, this is a song, and no matter, maybe not for the twos, but for the threes and definitely the fours and fives, to write the lyrics to your songs on experience chart paper. And when you do that, the bulk of it will be in black marker, but you're gonna, let's say the word sukkah, if that's repeated, every time you write the word sukkah, write it in green. Every time you write the word edro, write it in yellow. For any experience chart thing. So even though I'm three, I can't read, but I'm gonna remember that green word is sukkah because it will be repeated for you. So this is, goes to the tune of Bumping Up and Down in My Little Red Wagon. Anybody know that song? It's an oldie.
Yeah.
So help me, all right? Sitting in the sukkah, sitting in the sukkah,
sitting in the sukkah
on a sukkah day. Oh no! The wind is gonna blow! And you blow! There you go, the wind is gonna blow! Oh no! Oh, and they love when you do this. Oh no, and you tell them, they're the oh no part, tell them the thing. Oh no! Our sucker fell down, we're gonna have to fix it. How can we fix it, boys and girls? What should we do? What do we need? I'm gonna fix it with my hammer. So, I'm not good on this one. We're gonna fix it with our hammer. We're gonna fix it with our hammer. We're gonna fix it with our hammer for us. Okay, I would have the tools of it if you're gonna do this song. Have the tools there so Ephraim can come up with a hammer and do that. Okay. Now, what else do we do in the sukkah, boys and girls?
Eating in the sukkah, eating in the sukkah,
on a sukkah day. Oh no, the wind is gonna blow. There you go. Oh, our sukkah fell down. We're gonna have to fix it. What can we use to fix it?
Tape.
That's a new one on me. Okay. How about a saw? Cause that's in my. I didn't bring tape, but I sure said that's good. Okay, we're gonna fix it with a song.
We're gonna fix it with a song. We're gonna fix it with a song.
Okay, we're eating. What? Do you know my
the decibels are too loud?
It says it looks like you've taken a fall.
Okay.
So we ate in the sukkah, but I'm so thirsty. What else do we do in the sukkah?
Drinking in the sukkah.
Okay, cut. You got the routine. I don't want to say, okay? But the wind is going to blow. We're going to have to fix it. What can we use to fix it? I'll give you tape, okay? Or glue. Or a screwdriver. Or whatever, you know, you got the thing, but when you put that kind of a song on an experience chart paper, and what I do, and what I tell my people to do, is a chopstick. Always have a chopstick with your experience chart things, whatever you might put there, because and use it when you first intro the song, and leave the chopstick there, because they will love to be the teacher and use the chopstick as the pointer, and you'll hear amazing, wonderful things. Okay. By the way, so the end of that is all together in the sukkah,
all together in the sukkah, all together in the sukkah on the sukkah day.
And then you can add, if you want, well, the wind can blow and the wind can gust, the wind can blow and the wind can gust, the wind can blow and the wind can gust, but our super sukkah will stay up. Hooray! And we end on a Hanukkah. Okay, great. I'm segueing into Hanukkah, which is coming up, right? Which unfortunately we won't be in school for because it's during winter break. I hate when that happens. So you should, let me encourage you, do some Hanukkah things. So in our school, we invite all the parents to come in on for our Hanukkah Chagigah, our Hanukkah celebration. We start, everybody is in the ballroom. We give out song sheets. We sing a lot of stuff. We light the Hanukkiah. And then they break up and go into the ballroom where we have Lahavdil, the stations of the cross, I like to call them. Different hands-on experiential things that they can engage with their parents. And we have all different Hanukkah stuff for them to do, loose parts, and I don't have to tell you that. But when we're all together with the singing, this is, anybody in a school where they do something like that? Well, I highly urge you to think about doing that. It's a wonderful way to connect with parents, first of all. Are you all teachers, but are there any directors? Okay, so you might want to mention that to your director. It's a beautiful way to connect with families. They will love you when they see the great things. So, what I'm going to show you are things that we do at that thing with the parents or the clergy or whatever. So the first thing we do, we make, and you can do this with your children. This got wrecked in transit, but this is my frying pan, right? Okay, frying pan, because we're gonna be making latkes. And I put on the apron, and I have somewhere here a chef's hat. You have to look the part. The costume is half of the story. Mm-hmm. You need to. The more, any prop, anything, kids love it, and it juices things up. Okay, two volunteers. Come, thank you. Perfect. Here.
Me too. I love the latkes.
So these are latkes. Now we do, come here, please.
Here.
Again, you can make this in little and do it with the children because we do it. I have the rabbi, the cantor, the assistant rabbi come and do it. I have the frying pan here and they sing. Five little latkes sizzling in the pan. One jumped out and said,
"Catch me if you can."
So she ran and she ran all around the kitchen floor. And when we turned around, she ran right out the door. So we do that in the ballroom, and you've got to see the clergy running all over the ballroom. It's great, and they do run out the door. We do five. They love also. Children love seeing the grown-ups do it. They. Thank you. You get a chance. One. Oh, boys and girls, how many latkes are left?
One.
Clearly, four, three, two, but now four, Rachel.
One little latke sizzling in the pan. She jumped out, said,
"Catch me if you can." She ran all around the kitchen floor. And when I turned around, she ran right out the door. And then we do bring those latkes back. And they get to eat latkes at the end of this little thing. But thank you. I'm just giving you an idea. Now I need four lovely volunteers. Four. Good. One, two, three. One more.
There.
Where? Great. Okay. So you're getting the letters of the dream.
Gemma,
put them out here like that.
Okay.
And get yourselves. I want you to make a dreidel. Link arms facing out. Dreidel has four, right? Link arms and then hold it. You got it? They're good. Are you
in order? They hurt themselves.
Okay, here we go. You're gonna go around, and I'll be appropriate in a moment. You have to try.
Which way are we going, left or right?
You can decide that. And at the appropriate moment, everybody's gonna fall down, but Gimel. Okay. I make the fathers do this at that moment. I make the dads do it because the dads never get to do it. Right. So here we go.
Nice.
I'm a little teapot. I'm a little dreidel. Watch me spin. Here, time. Sorry, I got to tell you. When we say your letter, hold your letter up, okay? Here is my
good shin.
When I finish spinning, down I go. Down I fall. Gimel.
I know.
Gimel. Gimel. And the day
here. Encore?
Encore.
And they all go encore, so we make the fathers do it again and again. The kids love to do it. And you can do this with the children in your quiz, you know, and they'll want to do it 1,000 times. For lack of time, I'm just sitting through it. Thank you, Pat. Okay.
Anyway, but I'd like to have it to like memorize the words.
You get this.
She gets up dying.
Don't show us that.
Hide it.
And you get Lambie. We do Rosh Chodesh in our school. Does anybody do the Rosh Chodesh? Okay, so this would be something that I introduce every Rosh Chodesh. I try to introduce it, a song, a game, a thing. And this is the one I would do for Kislev, the month that, but you can do this in your room whenever. Boys and girls, good morning. My name is Shira. My daughter's real name is Shira. And she's blonde, so it's very close to my heart. Boys and girls, I'm so excited because Purim is because Hanukkah, he threw me on. Because Hanukkah is coming up, and every year I make my Hanukkah party. And boys and girls, what do you think I serve at that party?
Latkes.
They love my latkes. And what do you think we play at my party?
Dreidel.
We play dreidel. It's so fun, and we win so many pieces of gilt. But the most important thing we do at my party is we light the Hanukkah. Wait right here. I'll be right back. There is my Hanukkah. I was busy polishing it. Isn't it shiny, boys and girls?
Yeah.
But, oh no, I don't have my shamash. I need my shamash candle for lighting. I'm looking for a candle, a very special one. I think I'm going to ask my friend. Maybe she has one. I'm going to go to my friend, Cat. Cat! Boys and girls, help me. Cat!
Hello, Cat.
Hi. Oh, Catty, how are you today?
I'm good, and you?
Catty, you're going to come to my party, aren't you?
Yes.
But, Catty, now ask me, young you. Are you going to have your delicious latkes again? Like, let's juice it up a little. Will you have your drink? Don't forget your pennies for our drink. Okay, blah, blah. You got that part. But, Catty, I have a problem. I took out my Hanukkah. I polished it. It's so shiny. But I don't have a candle for the Shabbat. They love when you pray. Do you have a candle I could borrow, Catty?
Yes, I have one.
Catty.
Uh-oh.
That isn't a Hanukkah candle. Boys and girls, what is that?
Oh, that's a Shabbat candle.
That's a Shabbat candle. Well, Miriam, Catty. Thanks anyway. I see you at the party. I'm looking for a candle, a very special one. I think I'll go and ask my friend. Maybe he has one. Doggy.
Are you going to have your party?
Well, of course.
Is there going to be latkes?
Yes.
Doggy, so excited.
Of course you're invited. I can't wait to meet you. You're going to love. But, Doggy, I have a problem.
What's the problem?
I can't find a shamash candle. I'm trying, honey.
I have a candle.
You got a candle.
Doggy, you have a candle for... Doggy.
Uh-oh.
Boys and girls.
No.
What kind of candle is that?
That's a Havdalah candle.
That's the candle we use at the end of Shabbat. But I'll keep this. What should I do, doggy? Go to...
Do you want to go as she?
Go to she, yeah, Lammy.
Go to the she.
Okay, maybe Lammy. Okay, bye, doggy. Bye. I'm looking for a candle, a very special one. I think I'll go and ask my friend, maybe she'll have one. Lammy, oh, Lammy.
Hi, how are you?
How about some bat? Bye.
Bye.
Oh, yeah, by the way, you a cat and dog. Because I don't know.
Birthday.
Ducky, can you help me out here?
Let me look in my toolbox.
Oh, thank you, Ducky. Ducky's such a good friend.
Oh, I found something. I think this is it.
Yay! Perfect,
Yay!
Ducky.
Yay! We did it.
Yay!
All right, you got the routine. Da-da-da. Now, when we do this first for the children. The teachers do the animals, whatever, and then we put it in the room, and then they act it out themselves, and they love it, and it's fun. There you go. Okay, thank you.
Have you ever tried to actually do it with your kids?
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying.
No, I'm saying you're saying that like first you do it with the teachers. To,
yes.
Like,
first we model. I always model.
But like after you model, have you ever tried to do it like in a circle time with the kids?
Yeah, well, a teacher will take it. It'll be in their classroom. It'll be out, and she'll come back. Yes. If she wants to do it more structured, you know, and review it. But at this point for them, I'm just happy if they get any parts of it. You know, the names of the candles or the animal sounds. It's fun. I'm all about fun. And, you know, maybe the fourth time they might do it, maybe they'll do it exactly the way I did it, but not my focus, necessarily. Okay.
Don't forget.
Yes. Maha. Okay. Good. Again, later. Not yet. Okay.
Good try.
Oh. I didn't, unfortunately. Make believe I had a big dreidel. It's just another quick game. Your kids are sitting in the circle. Pass the dreidel, round and round, round and round, round and round. Pass the dreidel, round and round, and let's see where it stops. Kid, where it stops, comes in the middle and does a Sippy Bone dance to some music or whatever. And after you do that a couple of times, put two dreidels and send them in different directions. Pass two dreidels, round and round, and then see what they do when Johnny gets both dreidels coming in there. But whatever it is, it's fun. It's a fun thing. Pass the dreidel, round and round.
Especially before they can spin it.
Yes. Excellent. Okay. Tu b'shvat. Tu b'shvat. Okay. Let's see. We're about 18. We're a small group, relatively. Well, actually, kids, you wouldn't have a bigger place than this anyway, because if you did, you should quit. Okay. Who wants to play? I need some. Who's good? Apples.
One second. You're gonna play whether you like it or not. Okay. Banana.
Bananas.
Pear. And peach. Okay, and then we're gonna go apple, banana, pear.
Pears. Ooh, there's a pear here. Pears, peaches, apples, bananas.
Okay, so the people who have fruits could... Oh, no, no, no.
You're not going to do anything.
Okay, this is a really... Once the children get the hang of this, they love it.
You know what? I'll give you an apple. Can you play or are you busy?
Okay. All right, this is how we do it. In... Actually, we can. How do I... I'm so selfish. Here. Thanks. I thought I could talk. Okay. Make believe. So you're sitting in a circle with your children. You introduce the fruit. It's to Bishvat, what grows on trees. You do all the preliminary. And now you're going to play this game. And you want to give out these fruits. Like you don't want apple and apple sitting next to each other. You want to spread everybody out. Now, so you're not, just make believe you're not here for this, okay? But in essence, there's somebody in everything. Yeah. I'm in the middle. What are to demonstrate it, I'm in the middle, and I'm going to say peach. If your fruit gets called, you have to get up and switch chairs. You have to go sit somewhere else. You can't go back to the chair you came in, but I'm going to be trying to get a chair too. Bishvat, peach. Go, peaches.
To Bishvat.
Hello. Mary, why are you standing? Do you have a peach? So you said. Okay, so poor Shara. She didn't get the chair, so I did. So I'm holding the peach, and Shara's gonna go two bishvat and a fruit.
Oh, two bishvat and pear.
Pears, go! Pears, go! Get out of here. Okay, so give yours to Shara. Okay.
Two bishvat.
An apple! Apples! Go, apples! Hello, Sherry. You're gonna do it again.
That would happen, definitely.
You wanna try and get a chair. Let me, I'll give the instructions.
No, Amy, you were playing the kids.
I beg your pardon?
Apple, it's not the Shivat Aminim.
These are not Shivata Minim, they're just fruits that grow on trees.
Apple, it's not a Tubishvat.
No, I know, neither are a lot.
Pear.
Or peach.
Zalokashul.
Okay, so peach is not a Tubishvat.
Right. Zerak pre Shagodel Alayitz.
Okay,
Lokashul.
And I guess when you're doing it, you can choose other fruits.
Yeah.
Right, you can do
it. Yeah. Okay, success.
All right, Amy. What are you going to do?
I'm
going to
take a chair.
You're going to take a chair. Okay, Amy, hit it.
All right, two bishvat. Apples.
Apples, again. Apples. Go, apples, go. Miriam. What did Miriam do wrong?
She went back to her same seat.
Can't go back to your same seat, Miriam.
No, I was there. I was sitting there.
You had traded. How did that
be? I was sitting there.
Oh, you were there before. Let's say it again. So, wait a minute.
She said apples again, but
yeah. Okay, so give it to Amy. Give it to Amy.
Here,
Amy's here.
Because my first one didn't count. So
right. Okay. So now I want to tell you, as you play this game with the children, this is what you're gonna say. Just here, sit down. Okay, I'm gonna say bananas. No, I'm gonna be, you Mon, go, no, no, go. No. Say banana, say anything.
Peaches, no, I'm just kidding. Bananas.
Bananas, go. I make believe I have a banana. Let's say apples was cold and I had apple, right?
Yeah.
Apples! I'm gonna like, you'll find kids, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They are not running for any chance. They want to be the kid in the middle.
Oh, yeah.
They'll find that a lot. So you have to address that in some way.
Yeah.
Okay.
We also used to play that game. It was, and we would say, fruit basket upset. And that meant everybody.
Everybody, yes, yes, yes.
Or a fruit bowl or anything.
Yeah.
So now, as I tell you the next, just can you pass these, we're going to collect the fruit to pass them around. Okay? But now, and when I do this, the first time I would do it, it's interesting.
There's my friend who said she got her name.
Oh, okay, so I do it initially with fruits that they recognize, and then I'll do it again, but I'll do it with some quote-unquote more exotic fruits, like an avocado, or a kiwi, or a, you know, whatever I had in here. I just, although now our kids are so worldly, whatever, they probably eat avocado on toast.
Oh, yeah, they do.
But you get, you know, you can play it again, thank you.
And he loves it.
Okay, now we're going to play a different game, and I need two volunteers.
Can I ask before you do that?
Yes, please.
What would you do to address the kid who's
who's meandering and doesn't want it?
Because it's usually more than one kid.
Yeah, so we say, what are the rules of this game? We just say, one of the rules of the game is that you run for a seat. There's no standing and twisting, right? And maybe one time I let him get away with it, but if the same kid does it again, we say, that's not, you know, whatever. You be the teacher. Okay, I need two volunteers. You are just the best. Lauren, come in. Ah, excellent. Diana, so this is what we're going to do. Come back. What I'm going to do is, Diana's going to close her eyes, and I
need my
phone. Yeah, you can go back where you came from if you wish. Diana is going to close her eyes. It's such an allegiance. You know, I have to tell you, one of my grandkids is four. He's four and a half. And there are three children in the family, and when they eat the meal, Kobe always sits there, Sophie always sits there, Eitan always sits there, and God forbid, Kobe, if you take his seat, he has an emotional breakdown. So my son taught him Makom Kavua, and if somebody, which means my set place. So if God forbid somebody sits in his chair, that's my Makom Kavua, and they have to move. It's just, I share that, A, because I love him and he's adorable, but there are so many opportunities to
throw in Hebrew
things with the children in your classroom as well, vocabulary words, like really an opportunity. Okay, Diana, you're going, holy moly.
Your heart rate is up?
No, but this is over in 15 minutes. Okay, I'm going. Diana's going to close her eyes. I am going to pin one of the fruits to her bag. And then you, Diana, are going to try to tell us what fruit is on her bag. She's not going to open your eyes, you're with us. She's not going to let you see the fruit on her bag. So you're going to be doing like jockeying for position to see your. Okay, so close your eyes, Diana. No peeking. We don't cotton with any peeking. Okay. So, Okay, Diana.
Yes.
Find out what is on Lauren's back. Go.
Do I get to open my eyes?
Yes. Of course. What are you, Houdini? How would you ever? Come on, that's it. Go, go, go. Okay, you're not allowed to use your hands. I should have said that. Hands behind your back. But she spotted. You spotted her banana. Right. Excellent.
There's no asking questions. No questions.
I would not.
Okay. So for two, this is trick. This one is tricky. Thank you, Gabon.
I know, Arvin.
The only. That's tricky. You have to know your people, and maybe this is something you do not at round two, but maybe later in the year. At the end of the year, you do it with Pesach symbols or. Okay, I need two more, just because this is fun. Two more people. Don't be ashamed. Two more. Excellent. Rachel and. Great. You want it on your back, or you want it?
She won't chase me.
She's going to chase you. Okay,
actually,
you
need to get my steps in anyway.
Okay.
Turn around.
I'm sorry.
So this is more gross motor than ask questions activity.
This is fun. This is just for fun. And they love. By the way, they'll do it 1,000 times. And then again, it's something you can do. Okay. It's let's go. Rachel, hit it. No touching. Go. Da 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 da. So wait, you, thank you.
You're welcome.
Really good. Thank you. But sometimes you will find, till they get the hang of it, she'll just sit in there and I'll go, oh, it's an apple.
Right.
I don't get it from the beginning.
Right.
But I have them do things. I said, go through their legs. Turn them, you know.
Oh,
they go all different cool things.
You should have done that.
Yeah. So you get one before you get the juice. Okay. Thank you, guys. Just to the topic of props and so on, I do a lot of creative dramatics with the places in my school, and when we do it, so we use props. We act out stories a lot. So, caps for sale. I bought a whole
love
bunch
caps
of
for
caps.
Sale.
And it just adds such another element when you do it, and acted out a million times. So I bought three gray, three brown, and also, so three, that's a great story for acting out. Three Bitter Goat Scruff, fabulous story to act out. Make the headband with the little horns, the bigger horns, the thing. Make some bizarro thing for the troll. Use the table in your classroom as the bridge. The troll is hiding under the bridge, and you can act that out. They love that too. And the third, oh, and this I just must share. Oh, by the way, this is that Sukkah song that I told you on experienced chalk paper, and we put some illustrations on there as well. So again, it's just an example. This is a pretty exotic one. You can start with a short song of doing that. But I have to do this because it means so much to me. I had a little 3-year-old, this was with a 3-year-old class. We were acting out five little monkeys
jump on the bed.
Okay? So we brought the class in. Who wants to be a monkey? No. Who wants to be, we read the thing. Then who do we need for a thing? We need a mommy. Who's gonna be the mommy? We get the mommy. Who's gonna be the doctor? We get the doctor. Everybody else is monkeys. Like if you had 8 more kids, you know, we don't hold by the 5. And again, the props added tremendously. So the kid who was the doctor, I had a little doctor's coat. And the mommy, we gave her, I don't want to say apron, it makes me sick. I don't know what we gave her, something mommy-like. And the kid, the 3-year-old child who was the doctor, I knew he could read. or run. He was like really along. So I gave him a pencil and a pen. I said, maybe you might need this, doctor. Avi or whatever. Okay. So they act it out. They do the thing. And then whenever you do a thing like that, it's always important to, reflect. You do the reflection after. How did it feel to be the mommy? Did you like being the doctor? Whatever it is. So they having a chat, but I saw that the kid who was the doctor had been writing. He was writing. So I said, doctor, I noticed you were writing some things. Would you mind sharing that with us? Now, this is what he wrote. I'm going to read it to you. Or you're going to read it to me. You're going to help me read.
Sure.
And this is what this was in, by the way, 2007. This is hanging on my bulletin board. I just made a copy of it because it spoke so much to me. So here we go. He's three. Can you read what that said?
Very.
Sugar.
Oh.
And it is an X next to sugar. Yeah. So don't eat sugar is what he was saying. Yeah. Then he wrote, get
medicine.
Medicine. It's not spelled correctly in any
way. But it's pretty
good. Look how she was able to get medicine.
Hurt yourself.
Hurt yourself. Because you go to the doctor if you hurt yourself.
Wow.
Band-aid. Iodine.
Oh. Oh. Get sick.
With an X next to the get sick, you don't want to get sick, right?
Check up.
You're good. And?
Well, no, that's check up. This one is get shot.
Get shot. And there's an X next to get shot. That's who the heck wants the shot. And
lollipop.
Lollipop. Now, what I'm trying to bring, thank you so much, you are really good at that. What I'm trying to bring out is that never would have happened that if I hadn't given the paper and the pen. And it's not that I'm so great, it just popped in my head. Listen,
it was in chronological order, like you said. It was like in order.
Right. But it was amazing.
It was amazing, yeah.
So that, I want to say. Okay, we have no time. Para. This is P-U-R-I-M, like bingo, right? You put them up there, P-U-R-I-M, then your P goes away, and you go, U-R-I-M, right? Okay, just really fast. The Humintoshin. So, you pick five kids, and they, some apricot, some prune, some raisin. You pick the baker, and you pick the customer. And, oh, here we go. I knew I had a baker's hat. Okay, so, and I give them, I give the customers a quarter. The price of Humintoshin has gone up. Used to be a nickel. Now it's a quarter. Okay, so they go, so here I am. And we have them dialogue. So they, Mrs. Cruz. I'm the baker. Mrs. Cruz, can I help you?
Sure. What do I say?
Are you in a hardware store or bakery?
A bakery.
Okay, can I help you, Mrs. Cruz?
I need a dozen Humintoshin.
Oh, you want to? I have so. What kind of Humintoshin would you like? I've got
apricot.
I've got apricot. You got a quart? I don't give it to you on your good looks, Mrs. Cruz. You got a quart? Okay, so. We give her the, Lord have mercy. Okay. Okay, so Mrs. Cruz should come and you take the kid with the apricot thing and it's, so it's fine. Open touch and bakery shop. One with yummy filling. Make believe I'm the apricot now. Yeah, one with yummy filling. They're oozing at the top. Then what? Chica,
yeah.
Quarter and.
To pay, she took the Humintoshin and they both ran away. Okay, so you're gone. Boys and girls, how many Humintoshin do I have left?
Four.
You got it, four, three, two, one, and they go. Okay, you got the Russian. Okay. God.
We're just seeing that.
Any chance we could get emailed a copy of this?
Yes.
Yes, of all these ones.
I have to do Israel just because it speaks to me tremendously, okay? How many people, are there any, don't be embarrassed. Are there any schools here that do not address Israel? You do Yom HaAtzmaut or something? Mm-hmm. I want to encourage you ladies to do Israel, not just on May 14th. Israel should be permeated throughout your school year, and there's many, many ways to do it, and if you want to know. Actually, there's a great workshop for the school. Paul, I don't know if anyone's going there. Yes?
I'm a teacher for two, and my class is teaching Hebrew. all my kids English. And that is, but this is my assistant, you understand Hebrew now, because I teach a kid. And Willie, a kid, Willie, and you talk to him, say Willie, I say the words.
Right.
And the kids got it, everything. My class is sing all in Hebrew, and everybody got it and understand. I'm not doing nothing in English.
Nice.
And you have everything for Davin in the morning from Israel.
Everything, I'm sorry.
For Davin. Davin,
Davin again.
And you have a special song for Chayalim.
What, which?
Mishem Berach Avotein, Rabban Mitzchak Ve'Yakov. And my kids, and I do this for Father's Day. This Bracha song, I do it for Father's Day. Everything, it's amazing. My kids got it, everything, because I don't know English to sing. I listen to what you say, but I do it everything in Hebrew.
Kol HaKavod, it's beautiful.
Yeah,
what we do in my school for Tehillah every day, when it's, we sing Oseh Shalom B'Morav, and every child gets a flag, so when they sing that, they wave their flag to when they march around.
This is a song finished at Davin, and this is Oseh Shalom B'Morav.
Okay, I'm going to give you a couple of quick songs, and then I'll do the this story, and you'll stay 2 extra minutes, and they think, and then.
Don't forget.
Machaser. Okay, I'm gonna get it. So, I'm gonna come home, you know that one? Come home, blue and white, the colors on my plate. Yes, I'm not, okay, here we go. I have my own Jewish country. I have my own Jewish country. I have my own Jewish country. And Israel, 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 Israel. There you go. Lots of people there speak Hebrew. Lots of people there speak Hebrew. You can again put it in. Many people there pray at the Kotel. Many people there daven at the Kotel. And our country's flag is kahol v'lavan. So try to put in some Hebrew words of it. Clearly I'm Russian today. But here is, I have to do this, this song. So, I mean this story. Because this is an easy one that you could do. So boys and girls, I take out the American flag. Anybody know what this is? Flag of America. What color is the flag of America? When a country's gonna be born, they have to decide on what their flag is gonna look like. And Israel was gonna be born. All the people in Israel were so excited that they couldn't decide what color their flag should be. So who should come along but Sahov? The flag of Israel should be Tzahov, because Tzahov is the color of the Shemesh, and there's so much Shemesh in Eretz Yisrael. We got the drift. And who should come along but Yarok? Yarok Tzahov, what's new? Oh, I'm just getting so excited because they're about to decide what color the Israeli flag should be, and I'm sure they're going to pick me, Tzahov. What are you talking about? They're going to pick me, Yarok, because there's so much Yarok and so many things growing all over Israel. Tzahov, Yarok, Tzahov, Yarok, and who should come along but
Katom.
Katom, what's your... And again, I'm not going to do them. They're fighting, they're arguing, but there's so much... Tapuzim in Israel, oranges, so they're fighting, they're talking, they're thinging, and who should come along but beige? Ooh. Sorry, I don't do home there, but beige. Because the Kotel is the color. It's such a, everybody goes in the craze of the Kotel, so they're all fighting and fighting and fighting, and who should come along but blue and white, kahol v'lavan. They were best friends. They did everything together. In fact, okay, I'm so rushing this, but basically, then what are you fighting about? Colors of the flag. Oh, what, don't you want to be the Israel flag? Oh, we have to do everything. 2 minutes. We have to do everything. We do everything together. We can't do separate. In